Hello there, everyone. This is Mark 3, and welcome back to the survival series, which will eventually be getting back to being a, you know, survival series. Yeah. Today I'm back in the workshop. No, not in the workshop. I'm back in the vehicle designer, continuing work on the Discovery prototype, which will be renamed once it becomes operational and deploys into the actual survival mode. And I'm going to pick up from where I left off last week. There have been some changes and some retooling since the end of the previous video, based on people's comments and feedbacks. And I would also like to apologize for not putting a video about this out last week. Or, well, any real FTD content last week, to be honest. It was just, last week wound up kind of being an unplanned break, and I'm not entirely sure how that happened. It was just a case of wound up not doing it and wasn't planned or anything like that. So yeah, that's the thing. Anyway, let's start going over what I've changed since the end of the previous recording. Mostly it is based on the feedback, as I said before. Though there is a little bit that I've tried to do too. First off, I've retooled the existing propulsion components to be configured for complex controllers. So this vehicle is now fully up to date on complex controller compatibility. So hopefully that'll help make this thing a bit easier to control. Next up, I have redone the oil refineries. As you can see here, they are much more compact, much more neatly arranged. And if I go down here, as you can see, they are two abreast, and I have actually vertically stacked them, using the fact that horizontal cooling stacks rather, will connect vertically as well. And so what I've made here is a whole bunch of very, very efficient refineries. If I drop them down to operational level, 57 material will give me just over 3,000 fuel. And I've got 10 of these things. So 570 material per minute to give me 30,000 fuel per minute. So this thing can replenish its fuel stores in a ridiculous hurry when the refineries are actually kicked into operation. And that's something I've tried to do and failed to do, so I'm not quite sure what I'm doing there, because you can't ACB control the refinery. So I've actually gone and done this. Actually, ignore that. Don't need that one. Remove that. Yeah, I've installed a lure block, and then I've tried to code a little bit and tried to get it working to toggle the refineries when I hit one of the keys, but it's not working. I don't know what I'm doing with it. But yeah, it's what I've got. I've got request complex controller stimulus 9, which is reacts to the complex controller on the O key. And then if the refineries are true, then set them to false for the bool logic. And then if it's already false, hang on, that's a typo right there. False. Apply changes. Still coming up with a whole bunch of errors, so there we go. Okay, right. I'm not sure if that did it or not, but okay, exit. It's been very, 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 very long time since I last coded, so yeah, I was never any good at really, but to hang on. D and O. I don't think that worked either. So yeah, they shut off because they went underwater, and now they're out of the water, they are up operation again. Nope, can't. That's not working at all. Me no good at doing that. But yeah, that's my attempt to code. It needs a lot more work. But the idea is, I want to, if I hit O, it's supposed to try and toggle the oil refineries, and it's not, so I don't know. Also, this is where the control room is going to be, by the way. Right, and the last thing is, There was actually a related video to this you guys probably saw, which was me putting out a custom jet testing rig. And that was me messing around with custom jets, trying to figure them out a bit better and things like that. And as a result of that, I've torn out two custom jets. Remember, there were four. And there's this new one in the middle. The ones on the sides are just there for comparison purposes only. And I'm about to tear them out. But this one generates 1,000 power. So that is pretty high. But then if I go across here, I've increased the length by roughly a fifth on this design, and it puts out 324,500. So it's, what, 20% longer roughly? And it's capable of outputting nearly double the power. So, yeah, that's the result of all that ratio testing I did and spent an entire day on for that custom jets rig. And that percent one uses the better ratios that I worked out. So that's why it's so good. Also, I didn't need to put in four in the first place because I am a complete dumb. I completely forgot about the fact you can just add in more fuel injectors to multiply the force of the engine. So I built four engines thinking, I need them because I'm getting this much power each, and then I forgot that I can just simply add that on there. So yeah, if I attach this underneath, sadly that doesn't quite work properly in appearance, but it is connected, then that gives this thing 650,000 thrust. By the way, if I did this in testing, and if I add all of these combustors with maximum fuel injection, it does something like 6.5 million thrust in total from this single jet engine. So lots and lots of power. Massive fuel consumption, but it doesn't really get any real speed because of the sheer amount of resistance it's having to do. So there is a diminishing returns thing going on with this, and there's no point really expanding it to that much power. And lastly, I've got the jets on a separate pair of keys compared to my usual forward, back, left, right in the custom controllers, so I can cycle up and power down the custom jets separately. And that's me pressing the T key, the jets triggering off. And then if I press the G key, that will slow down. And that's right next to the UJHK, which I've got the rest of the jets connected to. So that's what I've done between videos, and I've spent best part of 10 minutes explaining it, so... Oh, go me. Okay, let's go ahead and actually do something that was suggested, and that is add water propulsion to these things. It's not really going to do that much, to be quite honest. But hey, I figure, why not? Actually, that's a perfect width, isn't it? Okay, water, propellers, huge props. Like that. So, okay. And then forward, back. If I hit the left key, they need to go forward. And that's that. And then spread to all touching components. And there we go. Perfect. And then, of course, this side, just set that up reverse. Spread to all. There we go. Okay. That is fine and dandy. So those will work. Put them on the front here, though, is not really a good idea, but I'll try it anyway, just to see how well it does. Yeah, it's the problem really is, it says that it's a 1, but from whenever I've used this, whenever there's actually something solid behind, it always auto sets to a 0 after you try to use it, so that's why I'm not doing that. It used to work just fine, but they seem to remove that functionality quite some time ago, actually. But yeah, that's the thing. Anyway, moving on. I still have 50 minutes, and I plan to make use of them. What do I plan to use them for? Well, I plan to actually get this craft, you know, mobile. That is my rough goal. Get the craft mobile, and in respects to that, To get this crafting mobile, what I require is actually a whole bunch of extra thrusters plus a power source of some kind. I think I've got the feeling I'm going to have to like that, and then continue on was... Yeah, I think that's probably how it's going to have to be, isn't it? Then just like that. Yeah, that'll work. Okay. Just continuing that pattern there. So yeah, that's my goal for today. Get a power source in. Get steering thrusters in. And make it so this craft can actually function and operate by itself. And let's go ahead and install the slopes armor layer. Actually, no. This is the outer hull, so I want the stone layer here first. Like that. And I just put it in like that. And then it is the metal armor layer. And I must repeat my original affirmation. I will replace these with actual full-size blocks as and when I become available. Well, available? No. Able to do so. Yep, that'll do fine. Okay. So yeah, just reaffirming that I have not forgotten about that. Because I do consider that somewhat important. I want this craft to be legit, darn it. I want it to be legit, otherwise... Well, in all honesty, I don't actually tend to go for mods or vehicles that take advantage of something in some way. Here, yeah, I am doing it, but that is something of a rarity. And why am I on this topic again? I mean, seriously, why am I on this topic again? I think I covered this topic perfectly fine last time I mentioned it. Anyway, let's go to the middle here. And let's grab a prefab. Okay, I think about 50 odd should be enough. Yep. 57, 59, 60, 61. Increases. Oops, nope, that's wrong. Now, does that cover all of the things I just put in? More or less. I just need to drop the length slightly. And then increase the width. And that should about do it. So, capture that. And then just flip it around. And that'll put it in down there like that. Well, as soon as I... get it positioned properly, that is. Wait a second. That's right. I forgot. I did the things lopsided, so this isn't quite right, but I can just quickly go back in and get that fixed up for mirror modes. So yeah, let's do that. Wait. That actually looks alright. Yeah, that doesn't look bad. Just need to even out this edge a little bit, and then I'll have myself a keeper. So, okay. Why did I put that piece in there? Oh, wait, no, that's part of the original border, isn't it? Yep. Right. I think, actually, let's just go and do it this way. Let's just completely smooth out the edge, like... Yeah, that'll do it. That'll do it. I don't want to turn this into a hull doing episode, by the way. I don't want to turn this into a sculpting only kind of episode. That's not the plan. I'm just getting all this stuff there because it's a case of I'm trying to capture and copy and all this stuff. But what I want now is a bank of turning thrusters, which I'm going to work into it. So I don't want those to be. Let's put it here, actually. Yeah. Let's do it there. Anchor it in two places, just in case I do something stupid and accidentally erase it. Which, by the way, has happened once again in something else I was doing. I was working on the AM2 prototype, another robot. Well, actually not a prototype, an outright AM2. A new robot, and I was working on one of its special weapon pods, and I accidentally deleted like 80% of it by clicking on the wrong place. So, well, there's always something somewhere which reminds you that you are not meant to build like that. So, I actually swore at the screen when that happened, so stuff like that. But here I am, I'm relaxed, I'm in the mood, I'm just fine. And yeah, that looks good. Okay. Now, what am I going to use? I'm going to actually use this assembly here. So, to make this easier, I'm going to capture this assembly here and move this. It only requires a length of 1, 2, 3. That should be good enough, I think. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, 3's enough. Okay. Need the width down there. So yeah, I'm in a pretty good mood right now because I just came off Avorian recording. So I've been enjoying Avorian. I've been enjoying the To the Core set of videos. Though sadly, the Verge has fallen upon very, very hard times. So yeah, there is a definite difficulty spike as things turned out, but yeah, that was to be expected. And I'm in the middle of recovering from that. I'm enjoying it. So you know, that's my main factor really. Am I enjoying recording it? And that's the thing that tends to determine if I record a series or not. I think that's in the right place. Yes. Do that. So that's why there's also the things like North Guards and stuff appearing on the channel too. And this week is going to be flat out come on you moron, actually get stuff done kind of week. So I am going to be working on getting stuff done and actually getting videos out and stuff like that. I mean, I think I'd started out quite nicely on Monday when I actually managed to get 3 different series videos out. So that was a very happy start for me. And it's like, okay, you've made a good start. Now continue. Do it more. There, yeah. What I'm doing here, by the way, is I'm using these blocks to replace them with jets, so like that. Because for the custom mapping, let's actually do that now. As you can see, they've got all the custom mapping, which was when they were pointing the other way. So I don't need them to respond when I'm pressing the forward or reverse keys. That's really simple. If I hit that, I want these guys to run in reverse, and that, they want to run forward. And then if I hit spread, that should have copied to all of those, yep. And thanks to those ones I put in, they've actually spread to these ones back here, and the rest of the assembly up here as well. So now I can just, well, I can't just yet, I've got to actually go over here and do the same thing. Since, you know, I almost messed myself up there, not quite though. Let's see, this one, if I hit left, they're supposed to fire. And that one reverse. Okay, that's all fine. And spread to it. Now I can safely remove those because those were bridging parts, and so that's all fine. Yep. Sadly, these ones aren't bridged because they aren't actually nice and neatly stacked one-to-one kind of place. They're actually interwoven, so I've got to set each row of these up separately. So like that. Yep, that's correct. And then if I do it like just the same, So just go right through it, get all the rows set up. I'm quite very glad about that spread to touching components though. That saves a lot of fiddling around. I mean, if you saw when I first started to do complex controllers, when I was actually using catching a prefab of it and then just putting it down where I wanted it and then wiping and redoing the prefab, that was having the same kind of effect, but it was a whole lot of extra busy work. This is much simpler if you can get the things connected. How far is it actually doing this? Right. Yep, that's the right way. Come on, get your head together. And that, yep. And I think that's right, so let's double check with this. And yep, that is all correct. Okay, those banks of thrusters are now configured for turning control. Yep, that's just fine. You can, it works for wheels as well, by the way. Though wheels, you can't do what I did with the jets. If you've got separate rows of wheels facing opposite directions, you've got to do them one at a time. So that's something to be aware of too. And then there's some stuff that needs to be added in here to make sure the complex controller is fully set up properly. And that's ACBs, two pairs. Right. ACB, complex controller. Your left, your right. Okay, and I don't really need these, to be quite honest. But since I'm going to configure this thing with an AI and stuff like that, even if I'm not going to have it on movement mode, really, I need to set these up so that they work with the complex controls configurations, so they work properly. So like that. Okay, and then I need the controls and I have to calculate this again flat out. So reverse is J, I think that's 11, isn't it? No wait, or is it 21? J, no, it's 10 actually. There is one of them that's 11. Okay, K for right, that's 11. So is this the one that's doing that? Enter control to your right. Yep. Control 11. Then there's one that's 21. I believe that is the U, which means that one. Hang on. A, B, C. Am I doing this wrong? Right, am I messing up my basic alphabet? I wouldn't put it past me if I was, but yeah. Controls, set the control. This one's turning left, and that is H, so that is 8? Question mark? No, not that. 8. No. 8. Thank you. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. Yeah, that is 8. Okay, right. So I'm not losing my mind. Well, no more than usual, anyway. Forward, that is U. A, B, C, D. Damn it. Reverse was J, that's 10. Yeah. Okay, yep, that's 21. Sorry, I'm just... Every time I do this, I have to stop and recount. No. I have to stop and recount it to make sure I'm getting it right. And I think... actually... No, I need a new point. 1, 1, 2. I'm gonna make this easier on myself for all future instances where I need the darn complex controller setups. And that, by that, I'm going to do this. I've got all the four there, so I'm capturing that. And then you are being saved as complex controller AC set ACVs. ACVs, yes, send the ACVs. They can build all this stuff for me. I have a very, very, very serious urge to play on StarCraft 2. But yeah. Okay, right. I won't have to count that out again because I've just grabbed a prefab of it. So that's that fixed. Okay. Side jets will respond to the controls. Stuff like that. Tearing out the jets has given me a huge, huge, huge amount of space. Though I need to rearrange my fuel storage efforts. Because that is now part of the custom jet assembly and it's not a good place to have it. So, yeah. I'm just going to remove all that. As you can see, I actually knocked out part of the fuel storage just so I could install the custom jets. Okay, that's that. And there we go. Bye-bye fuel. I'm dropping massive amounts of fuel into the ocean and causing a ton of pollution, but that's neither here nor there. Anyway, let's move on. I'm going to install twin fuel silos, I think. And I'm going to put them in here. Okay, blast radius is 3. So that's going to be that. And then I want a layer of equipment and stuff up top here, which can help cushion the impact. So 1, 2, how much is this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Actually, yeah, that's fine. Yeah, let's do that. So the new silos are going to be like this. And I might as well... There's going to be a central wall here. So 1, 2, 1. And that'll be my new fuel silos arrangement. Yep, that'll do fine. Excellently. Right. Fuel. Yes. Fuel is going to go into here. I'm going to make them like this. That's going to be the coverage. Don't worry, the wood is not going to be their actual final... their actual final coverage there, but that is just... That's how big I'm going to make it. Fuel... I lose things at the strangest moments. I really, really do. Oh well. It's just one of the things that makes me so adorable for you people to watch, I suppose. No, I suspect not, and it probably irritates you as much as it does me sometimes. But yeah, anyway. 360,000 fuel. That is plenty, and those are a couple of silos in place there. So that's all fine. And... Yeah, that's okay for the exterior wall there. So that's going to be like that. And that's just a wooden fuel container for the time being. And of course there is like that. And there's the floor of the next section up, which is going to be like that. So yeah, that looks okay. That's fine. Okay. I now know where my fuel is going. And I've got it all marked out with wood. So that's going to be the fuel silos. There's going to be a vertical interior wall here. So there we go. And the next wall is going to be... actually, to keep it nice and neat... yeah, let's put it here. So there's a slightly larger gap towards the front of it and behind it, but yeah, that fits into the whole four arrangement that's going on. So yeah, that's going to be the internal structure of that section over there. Okay, I have fuel set up. Excellent. Now I need power. 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 Always the bane of any From the Depths craft, I think. Okay, right. What's my resource count at? 548. Right, I'm aiming for 700. Quite honestly, 700. Because then I know I have enough resources actually in the survival to build it and get it operational and going, so I can't build a super expensive power system. Don't I have to prefab? Yeah, here we go. There's the mile 5k engines like that, so I've got that, but I'm actually going to go for an FE max power segment instead. So this is like a 5k engine, but it's a segment, so it's intended for... I can go ahead and install these, and they will be maximum power density. So I can just start installing them like that. Yeah, so put them there. And then I just overlap that, and it just continues to build out, basically. Okay, so yeah, this is of course max density, so it's not efficient, but it works. It'll do the job. I can neaten it up later, or just absolutely gut it out later as well. My goal is to get a cheap and cheerful power source, and this is definitely a cheap and cheerful power source. It'll work. It'll do the job. It'll get me moving, and it'll fuel the steering and forward propulsion normal jets. But it's not going to be an elegant way of doing it. Okay, now I just need to plug in the actual generators themselves, which can go like that. I think that was that was the right way around, and that gives me 27,200 power. That's definitely an admirable amount, so yeah, that's just fine. Quickly neaten up the exhausts, of course, because I am just an absolute sticker for a nice, neat exhaust system. For some strange reason, I'm not entirely sure why, but I think I mentioned this before. In this game, I can't start messing around with exhaust without having, you know, exhaust. So there we go. No gases. Enter or exit the system here. Receiving a boost due to clear flow of exhaust. Yep, okay, that exhaust is set in place. So both of these engines are now operational and I have bucket loads of power. So let's go ahead and test this and make sure that it's still working properly. It should be able to move just on its regular jets, and I did configure those water ones, didn't I? Yes, I did. I thought I did. Okay. So this should be able to just get lifting off now. Sadly, something I've noticed though is that... Oh yeah, I must point this out actually, that... This thing doesn't actually maintain its power. I've got to keep the key press down. But yeah, it's going 27 right now based on just that stuff. Though as you can see, it's bobbing up and down quite severely. The craft is getting a bit heavier, so maybe that's it. Oops. What am I doing? There we go. I was pressing the wrong keys. Maybe I need a drive maintainer. Is that what this is for? A drive maintainer? Anyway, let's hit T. Begin the magic. And it starts waving up and down a lot more. But as you can see, it's now hitting at roughly 61 meters per second forward velocity. So it's really decent for a craft this size, but it's just bouncing back and forth so much. Yeah, I guess I do need that drive maintainer, don't I? Anyway, let's try steering. It can turn, it's turning! Look at it go! Oh, it's setting all sorts of records here. It can turn! Yeah. Man, this absolutely sucks at turning. Oh, well. I shouldn't have expected anything else, really, because it's like... Yeah. Yeah, the ACBs don't seem to function very well with jets. Sorry, complex controls really don't seem to respond very well with jets in terms of manual control. I suspect I need drive maintainers to correct that for the forward ones, but the steering ones are just suffering from a severe lack of power in all respects. So, yeah. Maybe I should use some custom jets for that. That's a thought, actually. A custom jet would actually be a big help for turning around like that. But right now, this craft is so full of smoke and fire and stuff, it's just unreal. Anyway, let's do another test while we're at it. This thing can do 60 as it is right now. So, let's go ahead and install an additional fuel system here. It drains 17,000 per second, so the refineries can actually supply 28,000. The refineries can actually supply this much per second, so it can actually run itself straight off its material reserves at this level. So, full power. What's its top speed now? A 50% increase in fuel has resulted in about 10 meters per second more. So yeah, diminishing returns are definitely kicking in right now. So it becomes a question of burning lots and lots of fuel, doesn't it? So, let's go ahead and do that then. Let's do that. And do that. Oh yeah, something else I mentioned actually about the custom jets is a lot of the back and forth saying you should stack jets rather than this is because it's not a fact that if you double the size, you double the power of the custom jets. Oh wow, look at that. I'm hitting I'm passing 80 on this thing. Now all it needs to do is be able to turn. That is still a problem. But yeah, if you double the size of a custom jet, you treble roughly its power output. So there is that. And then as you saw there, I just whack on an extra fuel system and it immediately increases the jet's power that way as well. So that's why these things are so good in terms of raw thrust for their cross-section. Though I also see the points made that they are actually quite vulnerable to getting damaged if they start getting hit, because it's very easy to greatly damage a custom jet. That's why you need to actually watch out for them and protect them. So yeah, stuff like that. And that's enough of that. Yeah, I'm happy with that. Just go ahead and grab it back in build mode and caps lock it. So, here we go. Come on. Out of the water. Stop swimming around. I've got other things for you to do today. Okay. There's something I need to test, actually, really quick. Let's expand my control room area. And add in a drive maintainer. I suspect this will solve the issue I was just having. Though I actually need two drive maintainers. Yeah, I think I need two. If they work the way I think they do, and if I can actually find the thing. Yeah, control. There we go. I swear. I'm losing everything today. Anyway, right, yeah. Maintainer. Maintain primary drive. Yeah. So do I need to do that? Secondary drive is those two, because those are the keys which control the custom jet. Has that done it? Let's see. Nope. Okay, now if I go into here and set this to a primary system as well. Okay, yep, that looks like it's fixed it. Hang on. Nope, yeah. Okay, that makes it act just like it should normally. And that is a lot of fire. That is actually very warm, that. Okay, right. Go ahead and cut you off. I actually need to hold it to make sure So it doesn't, it cuts off a lot more slowly than it would normally, because it starts cycling it down again. So yeah, spread to all those. Primary, spread to all those. Yeah, I need to get this all set up. Spread to all those. But basically, I have completed the goal I set. So, thank you very much for watching. Go away. This video is now over. I am through entertaining you. See you later. And you will watch the next one because you know that is not a satisfactory ending. So, yeah. Good wins. Or not. Whichever. Actually, I think some of my craziness is leaking out on this one as well. Anyway, yeah, I've still got another 20 minutes of this video left to go. If you guys are actually watching this and thinking, when is he going to shut up? That's when, about 20 minutes. So yeah, that's all fine. That's all fine. I don't need to maintain the drives on the other ones, so that's all fine. Just need to make sure that all of these are set. That should be all of them, I think. Yep, that's all of them. Okay. Those are all working just fine. Okay. And now I just need to set my custom jet back here onto the secondary. So that will maintain the secondary jet just fine on here. So if I hit T, then I release it, and yep, hey presto, it works. So goody. Right, now then, should I do this, should I not? Why not? Okay, there was something I was just debating if I should actually add or not, and that is, well, I was going to explain this in a build video which I was doing for Hover Tank, but I've managed to mess that up quite royally, so I might as well do it here. And it is something I came across while working on the custom jets. Like that. Yes. How do I want this to be? This is it's very much a aesthetic thing, but it is actually a rather nice, fun little aesthetic thing. At least in my opinion. So, you know, it's a take it or leave it kind of deal. It's up to you if you want to make use of it or not. Anyway, what I discovered is you can use custom jets in a purely cosmetic fashion, which is what I'm doing here now. So that's what I mean like that. Yeah. Okay. So yeah, you can use custom jets in a purely cosmetic fashion. And actually, I think I want all this to be one further back, so hooray for changing my mind. Svorty, my friend, you said I don't change my mind and I get things well. This is what happens when I do change my mind. It's like I wind up deleting an entire section, and then it's like, you've got, you get to here, so yeah. So yeah, I want that slightly exposed like that, so that's fine, and then I can use that. So what I've found is this, you can use the custom jets to get a flame out of them, but you don't have to actually spend any fuel on them. So if I set them up like this, and then set them up like that, so yeah, like that. And then I just add a controller to them. And like that. There we go. And that's all it really needs. So, back, secondary. And this one is that, secondary. Just get them all configured to the same keys. Yep. Well, you saw there that one promptly tried to ignite, so that tells you what it does work. So, like that. And now, when I hit secondary power, oh, look at that! They are all operational. Including the ones that have absolutely no right to be operational. So, yeah, that is something you can do by way of cosmetics. I have 6 engines in the back of the craft, but only one of them is actually doing thrust. The other 5 are just there for looks, really. So, yeah. Neat little trick that, and I've been having some good fun with it, playing around. It's very striking to add to your vehicles and build a vehicle around it. My hover tank that I'm working on, that actually looks rather nice. Very evil and burny, I think is a good way to put it. But yeah. Is G into it? Yep, just shut them off. Okay. So yeah. What it turns out is that all you need to actually produce the flame effect from your custom jet is to have a control jet controller here and a jet combustion chamber, and that's it. Those two together can produce the flame, so long as you've got a constant input on them to, you know, make them think they're trying to go forward. So you can do that with an ACB, you can do that with a drive maintainer, which is what's happening in this case when I've tied it to the same system as the existing one, and stuff like that. And it works on spin blocks and stuff too, so you can angle them and have all sorts of fun like that. So yeah, there's some really good stuff you could do with these things. I like them, and I'm thinking of actually building my third mech based around them as well, like I'm building the hover tank based around them, and it's taking an absolute age to do, because when I try to build to appearance, well, you've seen me building to appearance, haven't you? Yeah. Think how slow I go sometimes building to appearance here when I start to sculpt a vehicle, and then imagine me doing that from the very start of the build, and you get the rough idea. So, yeah, it's not good at all. Do I want to do like that? Yep, like that. Whoops. Didn't mean to do that. Mm-hmm. Is that in the right place? Not quite. I want it to be there. Yeah, that'll do. Okay. And I'm not letting it drop off. So yeah, custom jets can be a really fun thing to play around with. I actually like them quite a lot. They just look so much cooler in some ways than the standard jets do. And that's another reason why I like them. Let's get some stone blocks in here and straight down the side there. So, yep, there we go. That's starting to turn in. And then I can round this off to make the rear section of the tank. So, tank. I think I've been focusing too much on building tanks lately. I think I've done like 4 different tanks of late. Yeah. I'm also working on a nuclear bomber as well. It's like, I think I've actually got a viable system worked out for it. It works, sort of. It drops nuclear bombs, so hooray, it works. Sort of. That's the rub though, isn't it? It's a sort of kind of thing. But yeah, I can build nuclear bombs now. I can do nuclear bombers and stuff like that. So that is very much a thing. And it works, sort of. It's temperamental, just like most ACB systems are, but you know, you can't have everything. And I will show it to you when I've got the bugs worked out and I'm happy with how it performs. Now that said, I am not going to arm this thing with nukes. No. That kind of goes against the point. Very much so. I still want to do that melee-based survival game, though. That is still on the do list. The infamous do list. I should trademark that. My to-do list TM. No one may speak of my to-do list except for me. Oh, God, I hate my to-do list, actually. It's just blech. It's stuff I'm refusing to let go of and stuff I really want to do, and then I start feeling awful because I'm not doing it, and it's like it's a vicious cycle. But it's still there because I still want to do it, so I can't win, basically. I can't win at all when it comes to my to-do list. Because I'm a lazy sod. At least that's what I keep calling myself, so yeah, this is what it is. Believe what you like. I don't mind. Either way. And there we go, that's connected to that. So we've got a back ring starting to appear here for the crafts. That is good. Though that said, something I should point out is I am not actually happy with the with how erratic the system is when it keeps dipping into the water. Let's work on the underside actually now. No, I've got something else to do. Yes. I'm actually going to start installing batteries and RTGs. Yep. Actually, I can't do that. I can't really do that because I need to keep an eye on the cost. So, I can't just like whack in loads and loads and loads of these big things because that would just take all of my resource allocation, and then it would be a case of, hey, this thing's too expensive, you can't put it into your survival anymore. It's like, no, but I put so much work into it. Tough, you can't put it into your survival anymore. Haha, sucks to be you. Yeah, stuff like that. So, yeah. Wait. Woods. Let's get a wood beam, actually. I want this to be here. Might as well. This is the armored center of the craft, so there, then I'll wall off the refinery sets there, like that. So that's the wall there. Sorry, a floor there, rather. Like that. And that's going to be like that. And this is going to be a RTG location because it's buried really deep inside the craft, so it's a good place to have RTGs. Because they're not likely to get killed here, so that is kind of important. Let's actually put in some big ones. Actually, should I build an RTG core? Yeah, I like the idea of that. Let's put it like that, so there's space around either side of it. Mm-hmm. Like that, I guess. And then let's grab some 4 meters. And there we go. That's nice and shiny. Hey! Right. We have started an RTG core. Right. And then let's add some. Like that. Actually, let's do it like that. Look at me, I'm actually doing aesthetic stuff. What the hell am I doing? I don't know. Okay, custom jets. Custom jets. I want to have a intake. Or should I go for a combustor? Let's try a combustor. Sorry, compressor on that. No, an intake. Turn it around. Yeah. So there we go. I am Mark 3. What the hell are you playing at? Messing around like this and just like, hey, I'm adding something pretty. But you don't do pretty things. It's like, yes, I do. Leave me alone. I do pretty things. I don't know what the hell I'm on about anymore. I really don't. But hey, as long as you guys enjoy listening to me, I guess it's okay, isn't it? So yeah, there we go. Yeah, and then I'll add some downside twos, just like one there. So that's the mounting points for the actual RTG core itself. And then suddenly, out of nowhere, this vehicle has some monstrosity, which has added about 70,000 resources to the cost, but it gives it a pair of advanced generators or something. I don't know. Look, leave me alone, okay? I have no idea what the hell I'm doing at all. I seriously do not. And yet I keep doing it. What the hell? Reconfigured? Yeah. Yeah. This is totally functional and a vital part of the craft. Yes. Oh, God. Seriously? Why the hell am I even doing this? Why? Just why? Come on, Iron Mark 3, stop it! Stop messing around, stop! Right. I'm sorry, this is not what you're here for, is it? This is, we're here to have a look at a build thing. We're not here to have someone giggling to himself. Oops. To watch someone just giggling inanely while doing something which doesn't help the build at all, but... yeah. There we go, so that's a thing. Yep. Oh, God, now... Why am I doing this? Why? Just why? Maybe I should just go all out and try to beautify something at some point. I don't know. Does that fit? I think it might fit. It does. Ooh. Sure. Truly a vital piece of the vehicle going in here. Actually, that should go there. What have I done? What have I done? Seriously, what the hell have I done? Oh, jeez. Oh, sorry. My throat is paying me back for messing around. I think that's what's going on. Oh. Resources. I actually want a cram cannon piece, don't I? Yeah. Sure. Okay. Oh, man. I can't believe I've done that. I just can't believe I've done that. Like, at all. Seriously. Why the hell have I done this thing? And why am I continuing to add to it? Why? Why? I'm sorry, I'm cracking up. I swear I'm cracking up. I can't believe I've done that. I can't believe I've just put that abomination into... Oh, jeez. Oh, fine. Let's add something useful. Oh, man. Why the hell did I do that? Why? I don't understand it. Like, at all. Come on. Hold it together. You're okay. You don't have to... Talk to yourself too. Okay. Last thing I'm going to do is just going to do something so it's actually useful, which is I'm going to start installing a battery bank over here. Can't have an RTG power plant without batteries, after all. Like that, I guess. Yeah, not like that. Okay, like that. There we go. And I'm sorry for wasting the last 10 minutes of your time and the last 10 minutes of this video doing that. It's like suddenly the urge overtook me. It was a case of go forth and take the pieces and mess around. And it's like, why? I don't normally do this. I don't normally build like this. And it's I just have. So. I am questioning my sanity so much right now. But the worst thing is I actually enjoyed doing that. So, it is what it is. Right. Resources. Electric engines. Like that. So a couple of battery banks with some power sources in. That gives it another 10,500 in terms of raw RTG source power. There goes my timer. So that is all the time I've got for this video. That is an hour. with something completely random tacked onto the end because, I don't know. Why did I do that? I'm looking forward to your comments below. Do you think I've done something useful? Do you think I should actually try to be more aesthetic in my builds and things like this? Because this is not normally something I do. Do you think I've completely lost the plot? Do you think I'm crazy? Do you think I'm Bloggle? Or do you think I'm a cheese pizza with pink polka dots on it? Or all of the above. All of the above fits as well. But mostly I think I'm just crazy at this point. Anyway, I've made some decent progress in the last hour, I think. I've got some steering capability now, though it's too weak. I really do think I need to ramp it up with some custom thrusters, as well as tool it up to be around the centre of mass, too. That'll probably help. I should probably add some water-based ones down there, too. That might help a bit, though I don't want to increase the drag too much. Yeah, there's more turning work to be done, for sure. But I've also installed fuel engines, I've installed batteries, I've relocated and finalised where I'm putting the fuel supplies. I've worked out all the bugs in the complex controller setup, so this thing is now actually fully mobile, even if it's still riddled with holes and its chassis is far from done. And I've built some vague abomination which is apparently called an RTG generator core. I don't know. And I'm still cracking up every time I look at this thing. But yeah, this has been Iron Mark 3. Thank you very much for watching. Didn't I already say that? I think I did, yeah. Anyway, I'll say it for the third time, just in case. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the show, and I'll catch you all some other time. Which should be actually later this week, since I'm planning to do a second build session on this thing this week, so I'm speeding up the progress. Yeah, I'll see you all later. I swear, I am going freaking nuts lately.